The Maidans of India are the nurseries of cricket. How's that? Is a cry heard in town and city suburbs, nowadays even in villages. Those who love cricket know of how the great Don Bradman learnt his batting in a backyard. Sunil Gavaskar began his cricketing career playing in a street with a tennis ball. It has, however, been said with profound truth that the game is greater than the players. These young people love the game. Most of them play only weekend and club cricket, or inter-school or intercollegiate cricket. A minority will move into the Ranji Trophy, and a few will graduate into test cricket. In this film, we should like to tell you of a few of India's great cricketers. Here is Vijay Merchant.
Test cricket for India started in 1932 at Lord's under the captaincy of the late Colonel C.K. Naidu.
Colonel C.K. Naidu, affectionately called C.K., was a legend in his own time. He was a good captain, a superb batsman, a medium-fast and off-break bowler, and the keenest fielder. C.K. was known as a prodigious hitter of sixers, rattling the coconut palms surrounding the Maidans of Bombay, following on the inauguration of India's national tournament, named after the great Ranji. C.K. twice led Holkar to victory in this national championship. Here is King George V greeting the Indian team. Gubby Allen and C.K. were the respective captains. A huge crowd turned up at Lord's to see the Indians for the first time. Including this 1932 test, England and India have played 75 matches. England have won 30 tests, India have won 11, and 34 tests have been drawn. Today, scoring at the rate of a run a minute in test cricket is regarded as virtually impossible. In C.K.'s days, it was different. Bradman, for instance, scored 209 not-outs in a total of 458 for 3 wickets in one day's play against England. That was C.K.'s brand of cricket. C.K. bestrode the Indian cricket scene like a giant for 30 years. He scored more than 10,000 runs and took 337 wickets in first-class cricket. He played his last Ranji Trophy match at the age of 61. When the cricket season was not on, C.K. always kept himself fit and kept his eye in. The President of India honored C.K. with the Padma Bhushan in 1956. We met Syed Mushtaq Ali when he was in his 60s at the Brabham Stadium when a benefit match was arranged in his honor. He was applauded by many thousands of cricket lovers. Mushtaq was one of the most elegant and hard-hitting opening batsmen in the history of Indian cricket. It seldom happens that an opening batsman dances down the wicket to hammer even the fiercest of fast bowlers. Mushtaq often compelled opposing test captains to set the most unorthodox of fields to contain him. Mushtaq played for Holkar and India. He scored more than 12,000 runs in first-class cricket, including 30 centuries.
You played your last test match in 1952 and your last first-class match in 1960, that's right? After all these years, I as your partner on the cricket field and at the crease would like to know why you insisted on playing that kind of cricket which was all aggression and no steady play. Could you tell us?
That kind of cricket was in my blood. And you know very well that Colonel Naidu was my guru and he teach me that way, so you must hit the ball hard whenever you can. So that was my theory.
But Mushtaq, tell me, please, how did you manage to play so much cricket and devote so much time?
You see, my father was not a very rich man. He belongs to a middle-class family. I used to go nearly 3 miles to play, to practice cricket. At that time, I had no bicycle also, no shoes also. And with great difficulty, we played cricket. It was a very hard way, Vijay. But then, as we have grown up, and then Holkar was always very much interested in cricket. Then when Kalnaidu came from Nagpur in 1926, his highness offered him a job, and then he saw me playing cricket. Maharaja Yashwant Rao Holkar got a job at the ADC, and that's how I started playing cricket.
Mushtaq and Mersham, a fine opening pair, scored 203 for the first wicket in the Manchester Test of 1936. They both scored centuries.
Which of your matches, Vijay Bhai, do you remember best?
From a personal point of view, two. One was the second Test match at Manchester in 1936. The second one was against Leicestershire, the same year. And in that match, in the first innings, I was not out with a score of 135 out of a total of about 270. And in the second innings, again opening the innings, when the last man got out, I was not out in 77. So I joined the select band of cricketers in first class cricket of a batsman opening the innings and remaining unbeaten in both the innings, which were completed once.
Outstanding right-hand batsman, one of the best left-arm spinners in the history of the game, and a brilliant fielder. That was Enu Mankar. His first-class career began in the 1934-35 season, but because of the Second World War, his international debut was delayed up to 1946.
Was an automatic choice for the Indian team's tour of England in 1946. It was befitting that he should make his debut in official Test cricket at Lord's.
The outstanding players on the 1946 tour of England were Merchant and Mankar.
In England in 1946, he helped me to put on 293 runs for the first wicket against Sussex at home. In bowling, along with Amarnath, he proved to be our trump bowling combination against England. And he became absolutely indispensable to the Indian side to such an extent that he only missed two matches throughout the tour. And he was the first and only Indian cricketer to perform the double, that is, score over 1,000 runs and capture over 100 wickets. Indeed, a grand all-round performance and a feat not repeated by any visiting cricketer in the last 26 years.
Mankar achieved a double of 1,000 runs and 100 wickets during that English summer. This feat has not been achieved by any Indian to this day. It was here at Lord's, 6 years later, against Len Hutton's team, that Venu scored 72 in the first innings and 184 in the second. He took 5 wickets, and all of England called that game Mankar's Test. The Queen congratulates Venu Mankar on his magnificent challenge to England. Apart from Hammond and Bradman, Mankar is the only batsman to have scored 2 double centuries in a Test series. Mankar and Pankaj Roy scored 413 for the first wicket against New Zealand at Madras during the 1955-56 tour. This world record stands to this day. Mankar scored 11,500 runs and took 776 wickets during his first-class career. He was the first Indian to take 100 wickets in Test matches. His final tally of 162 Test wickets would assuredly have been greater if he had had the support of the sort of close-in fielders who served Indian cricket in later years.
When do you think the cricketer should retire?
The cricketer should retire when he's still good enough to play for his team and his country. In other words, when people will ask why, not when they start asking why not. If he retires at that stage of his career, he has an extremely happy memory of his association with the game. His supporters knew him when he was at his best and not when he was on the decline. And finally, he gives a chance to the younger generation of cricketers to come up at a time when he's just giving up first-class cricket.